بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمد ونستعين ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام قام أمام الناس وصلى على المنبر عليه الصلاة والسلام وقال: إنما فعلت هذا لتأتموا بي ولتعلموا صلاتي.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the one who bestows mercy, indeed all praise is due to Allah, may peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood up on the minbar, on the pulpit, and he prayed in front of the people. And then he said, I have only done this in order for you to follow your prayers with me and in order to teach you how to pray.
وعلى هذا كان الصحابة والسلف الصالح رضوان الله عليهم يطبقوا صفة صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And similarly, the companions and the great imams of the Salaf who came afterwards, they used to also follow the method of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in teaching the prayer in a practical manner.
الأصل أن المسلم يتطهر في بيته.
So The base ruling is that a person, a Muslim, he should purify himself in his house.
يعني يخرج من بيته وهو جاهز للصلاة، متوضئ جاهز.
Meaning, a person before he leaves the house, he's already for the prayer.
يلبس أحسن الثياب.
And he wears the best of his clothes.
الأصل أنه يمشي إلى المسجد ولا يركب.
And the asl is that a person he should walk to the masjid and he doesn't not in a mode of transport. But if a person rides to the masjid, then no problem.
يأتي إلى المسجد بسكينة ووقار. السكينة في الحركات يعني لا يأتي وهو يجري، والوقار في الهيئة يعني لا يأتي وهو يلتفت أو يرفع الصوت أو يتكلم في الهاتف أو يشمر مثلا.
And when a person is coming to the masjid, then he comes in a state of calmness and at the same time with a level of dignity. And the meaning of being calm is that he walks slowly and calmly to the masjid. So he isn't running, he isn't jogging. And the meaning of coming with dignity is that in his appearance and how he is interacting. So he isn't shouting at people and turning left and right.
فإذا وصل إلى المسجد قدم الرجل اليمنى وقال الدعاء الوارد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And when he comes to the masjid, when he wants to enter the masjid, then he enters with his right foot and he says the supplication which has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ويترك الدنيا خارج المسجد.
And as he is entering the masjid, he leaves the dunya, he leaves the worldly affairs outside the masjid.
فلا يمكن أن يبيع ويشتري في المسجد.
So it isn't permitted for him to buy and sell whilst he's in the masjid.
يبحث عن الأشياء المفقودة في المسجد.
Or that he looks for his lost property in the masjid.
الغيبة والنميمة.
And similarly, backbiting, slandering.
اللعب في المسجد.
And playing around in the masjid.
لأن البعض هدانا الله يفتح الجوال على الألعاب ويبدأ باللعب أو البحث عن الرسائل أو بعض الأرقام حتى يعني يحذف بعض الأشياء التي لا تصلح.
Because some people, may Allah guide us and guide them, when they are inside the masjid, they'll open their phones, they'll open their mobiles. And this is to either play a game or to delete a number or to find a number.
أو يتكلم عن السياسة عن الحكام.
Or a person sits in a masjid speaking about politics, speaking about the rulers.
أو غلاء الأسعار.
Or how things have become very expensive.
أو يجعل المسجد كالفندق، مكان للأكل والشرب والنوم والاتكاء وحديث الدنيا.
And sometimes some people, they treat the masjid as if it's a hotel or as if it's a restaurant. Eating, drinking, lying down, stretching out the feet, speaking about the dunya.
لا مانع أن الإنسان يأكل ويشرب وينام في المسجد. لا مانع.
There's nothing wrong, there's nothing preventing a person eating in the masjid, drinking in the masjid, or lying down in the masjid.
لكن يكون هذا بقدر الحاجة ولا تتجاوز هذا.
But this has to be in accordance to the necessity, and a person shouldn't go overboard the necessity.
كإفطار الصائم مثلا.
So for example, a person giving food to the one who is fasting in order to break his fast.
أو ينام في وقت ليس من أوقات الصلوات المفروضة الخمس.
Or a person, he takes a break and he sleeps, but not in the times where the five daily prayers are being established.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال إنما يعمر مساجد الله. عمارة المساجد تكون عمارة حسية وعمارة معنوية. عمارة حسية بهذا البناء والإضاءة والفرش. أما العمارة المعنوية لابد أن نجعل المسجد عامرة بما أراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بذكر الله بالصلاة والاستغفار وقراءة القرآن والدروس والخطب.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, those people who build and maintain the masajid of Allah. This imara, this building and maintaining the masajid, it's of two types. Either the physical maintenance of the masjid, in terms of physically building the masjid and cleaning the masjid, looking after the masjid, the carpets in the masjid. This is the physical maintenance of the masjid. And there is also the spiritual maintenance of the masjid. And that is that a person, he fills the masjid as Allah has ordered him to do so, with dhikr, and the recitation of the Qur'an, and the spreading of knowledge, and the studying of knowledge.
وضد عمارة المساجد خراب المساجد.
And the opposite of عمارة المساجد, the opposite of building and maintaining the masajid, is corrupting and destroying the masajid.
الخراب أيضا خراب حسي وخراب معنوي.
So also this corruption of the masajid and the destruction of the masajid is two types, either physical or spiritual.
تفجير المساجد.
So for example, blowing up the masajid.
هدم المساجد.
Destroying, physically destroying and flattening the masajid.
رمي الأوساخ فيها.
Throwing litter, dirtying the masajid.
والقسم الثاني نجعل المساجد أماكن للعب واللهو.
And then the second type of corrupting the masajid is that which relates to the spiritual sense in terms of making the masjid a place of playing and joking and idle speech.
الشرك.
And also committing ashirk, ascribing partners to Allah in worship.
الأغاني والموسيقى.
And people listening to music and songs.
أو الألعاب.
Or playing games.
إذن لابد أن تعلم أن هذه المساجد بيوت لله سبحانه وتعالى ولا تتعدى على حق الله.
So therefore you have to know, you have to realize that these are the houses of Allah. And you don't transgress the limits when it comes to the house of Allah.
هذا الذي تراه يصنع أي شيء من هذه الأمور التي نهينا عنها تذكر بماذا؟
So if you see a person who is doing these things which we have been forbidden from doing inside the masjid, then with what should you remind him?
تذكر بالفيل. الفيل. You should قصة أصحاب الفيل.
You should remind him of the elephant, i.e. the story of the elephant.
هذا الفيل دابة حيوان بهيمة. نعم.
The elephant is an animal.
لا يتكلم.
Does not speak.
ولم يستطع أن يتعدى على بيت من بيوت الله وهو بهيمة حيوان.
And yet, in the story of the elephant, despite it being an animal which is wild and domesticated, doesn't speak, but it wasn't able to transgress and destroy the masjid.
يعظم الله ويعظم بيوت الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Rather, it would glorify Allah and glorify the house of Allah.
فما استطاع أن يخرب مسجد أو بيت من بيوت الله.
So that wild, undomesticated animal, the elephant, wasn't able to spoil, corrupt, or destroy the house of Allah.
لكن هناك ممن يدعي الإسلام في هذه الأيام يخرب المساجد.
And yet, nowadays there are those people who claim to be upon Islam and yet they want to destroy the masajid.
يدفن فيها الأموات.
So in some cases they deceased or buried in the masjid.
يضع فيها المتفجرات حتى يموت من فيها من المسلمين وتخرب.
Or some of them will place bombs inside the masjid so that the people who are praying inside the masjid they die.
بعد أن يدخل إلى المسجد ماذا يصنع؟
So after a person enters into the masjid, what should he do?
الأصل أن يتقدم إلى الصفوف الأولى ولا يتأخر.
That the base ruling is he should go towards the front of the masjid, the first rows, and he doesn't sit towards the back.
لأن الذي يتقدم الرجال ويتأخر النساء هذا الأصل.
Because those who are towards the front of the masjid, they are the men. And those who are towards the back of the masjid are the women.
فتقدم إلى الصف الأول.
So therefore, when he enters into the masjid, he goes to the first row.
إذا كانت الصلاة قد أقيمت وابتدع الإمام الصلاة يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام ويدخل مع الإمام في أي هيئة يكون عليها الإمام.
If the prayer has already started, meaning the one who is coming into the masjid is late, then he says the takbiratul ihram, which is the first takbirah, and then he joins the imam immediately in the position the imam is in.
إذن على أي هيئة الإمام عليها هو يكبر تكبيرة الإحرام ويدخل مع الإمام قائم أو راكع أو ساجد أو جالس.
So whatever position the imam is in, a person says takbiratul ihram, the first takbirah, and then he enters with the imam. If the imam is standing, he stands. If he's making ruku', he makes ruku'. If he is in sujood, he enters into sujood.
حتى ولو كان في التشهد الأخير يكبر ويدخل مع الإمام في التشهد الأخير.
And even if the imam is in the final sitting of the prayer, he says takbiratul ihram and he goes into the final sitting of the prayer.
فإذا سلم الإمام وانتهى من صلاته قام قضى ما فات.
And then when the imam finishes from the prayer and exits from the prayer by saying at-taslim, then the person who came late, he stands up and he completes the prayer what has missed him.
وتدرك الركعة بإدراك الإمام قائما أو راكعا.
And a person catches or fulfills a unit of prayer as long as he has caught the imam whilst he was standing or whilst he was in a ruku'.
نعم. وإذا لم يدخل وقت الصلاة مثلا لم تقم الصلاة بعد ماذا يصنع؟
However, if the person who came in, he came and the prayer has not been established, meaning the imam has not entered into the prayer, what should he do?
يتقدم إلى الصف الأول.
Firstly, he comes in the first row.
إذا دخل وقت صلاة من الصلوات بالأذان فيصلي السنة القبلية إذا كان لهذه الصلاة سنة قبلية.
And if the adhan has been said and he enters into the masjid, then he prays those recommended prayers, the sunan al-rawatib, before the prayer, if the prayer has those sunan al-rawatib.
وإذا لم يكن لهذه الصلاة سنة قبلية أو لم يؤذن بعد للصلاة ماذا يصنع؟
And if the person came early such that the adhan hasn't been given for the prayer, or if he comes early and the prayer does not have sunnah prayers before it, what should he do?
يصلي ركعتين.
The person, he should pray two rak'at, two units of prayer.
قبل أن يجلس.
Before he sits down.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه.
Some people, may Allah guide us and them.
يدخل.
They enter into the masjid.
ويظل واقف.
And he remains standing up.
ينظر في الجوال.
Looking at his mobile.
ويرفع الصوت بالحديث.
Or raising his voice with conversation.
أو يتكلم بأي كلام.
Or he speaks with general speech.
أو ينظر في الإمام مثلا أو المؤذن ينظر فيه. يعني أقم الصلاة.
Or he looks towards the Imam or the Mu'addin as if he's forcing them to get up and start the prayer.
أو ينظر في الساعة.
Or he keeps looking at his watch.
أو يتنحنح. حتى ينبه الإمام بإقامة الصلاة.
Or he'll gently cough just to nudge the Imam to start the prayer.
والله لا يستطيع يصنع هذا في بيت ملك من الملوك أو رئيس من الرؤساء. حتى في المدرسة أو الجامعة ما يستطيع يصنع هذا.
And this person, he wouldn't do these actions in the house of a king. or the residence of a minister. Or even if he's at school or college, he wouldn't do these types of things.